Hello, my name is Jimmy Costello from the Design Center NX product marketing team. Today we're going to be diving into Realize Shape and how it can be leveraged to take your industrial styling and design projects to the next level. Realize Shape is a powerful subdivision modeling tool that enables the effortless creation of complex, organic, and freeform shapes, often challenging to achieve with traditional parametric modeling. In this video, we're going to cover importing OBJ files, key commands such as transform cage, offset cage, and define work region, and a number of keyboard shortcuts to optimize your workflows along the way. Let's jump right in and get started. We will begin by importing an OBJ file to serve as the baseline for today's design. This is an excellent method to leverage designs created in other software, allowing Design Center NX to seamlessly integrate and complete them. Once imported, our razor's initial part will be ready for refining. Next, we'll modify the razor's neck to create a flatter surface. To do this, we can open the subdivision body in the Part Navigator to begin making changes in Realize Shape. Before we make any modeling changes in Realize Shape, it's important to turn on symmetric modeling. Symmetric modeling simplifies the modeling process, as we can now make changes on only one side of our model, and those changes will be reflected on the other side as well. To change a surface continuity, we can navigate to the Edit group and select Set Continuity found under the More icon. After that, we can select the faces or edges we would like to alter and the continuity type we want to apply. This is a quick and easy way to ensure smooth transitions between surfaces, maintain the desired aesthetic flow of your design, and achieve a high level of surface quality without needing to manually adjust every individual control point. Next, we're going to work with the Transform Cage command. The Transform Cage tool allows us to manipulate a selection of faces, edges, or vertices by deforming a surrounding cage or bounding box. Instead of moving individual control points, you can grab and push, pull, or rotate the cage's control points, and your selected geometry will follow along smoothly. One nice trick you can use when you are selecting multiple faces at once is to click on the front cage face of your boundary, and then perform an alt click on the far corner edge. This smart technique will automatically select all the faces that fall within the defined rectangular area, making it incredibly fast and efficient to select entire sections of your model for transformation without having to click on each face individually. As we begin to shape our model, one way we can tailor our design is by adjusting the falloff curve. This determines how the influence of a transformation, like moving, scaling, or rotating a selection of points or faces, diminishes over distance from the center of the manipulation. Instead of an abrupt change, the falloff curve allows you to create a smooth, gradual transition from the fully affected area to the unaffected area of your model. For our next changes, we're going to focus on creating an elevated bump to improve the ergonomics of our handle. To do this, we're going to start with the Offset Cage command. This allows us to move selected faces, edges, or vertices along their own normal vectors, effectively pushing them outward or pulling them inward from the surface, while maintaining their overall shape and curvature. With our new offset surface prepared, we can now define this new surface as our work region. This will ensure that any new changes we make will not inadvertently affect the rest of our model outside of this specifically defined area. Now we can jump back into Transform Cage, and this time we will use the shortcut key T to open the command. Once we're inside of the command, we can double-click on the outside edge of our cage to automatically select the entire outer loop of edges. To reorient the work coordinate system, we can right-click and select Align to Work Coordinate System. And one other shortcut we can use to improve our efficiency is to select the F8 key, which will snap our view to the nearest orthogonal orientation. Using a combination of the linear and planar scaling methods, we can shape our handle to meet our design needs. By strategically applying each option, we can fine-tune the handle's ergonomics, aesthetics, and fit, ensuring it feels just right in the hand and looks exactly as intended, without distorting other critical features of our design. Since our offset cage just created a sheet body, we will finish with the emboss body command to create a solid feature. After that's done, we can continue by making traditional modeling changes on top of our subdivision body. We'll wrap things up with an edge blend around the base of our elevated surface, and then we can move on to assessing the appearance of our model. If we go on to assign materials, we can explore how different material choices will impact our design's appearance. Selecting Control-A is a good way to efficiently capture our entire model at once. Taking this a step farther, if we do decide upon a material selection, we can jump into Immersive Explorer to get a higher fidelity view of our model. Here, we can experiment with different backgrounds to truly understand how our model will look after production. In conclusion, in this video, we have covered a number of key tools and commands to enhance your realized shape experience. We started off with the import OBJ and setting the continuity of our razor's neck. Next, we began to work with Transform Cage with the falloff edge capabilities. After that, we continued on, this time using Offset Cage and defining a new work region. And finally, we finished by using a few keyboard shortcuts with Transform Cage, embossing our sheet body, and selecting an appropriate material. I would like to thank you for your time and attention.